Hello everyone, and welcome back to another drawing time of Incroverts. This time we're doing another character design portrait, but this time I'm mainly focusing on talking about how I did the full body portrait, and I'm going to talk firstly my failed attempts, then how I decide on the poses, the outfit, and how I struggle to draw the face, and finally the rather important element for colouring is the three values. And without further ado, let's roll the intro first. Alright, first off, the final product of the character portrait looks like this. And then we started off not looking quite like the final product, but we'll get there eventually. This is sort of the failed attempt I did. I wanted to draw a sort of laid-back but confident character. He knows what he's doing, a bit antagonistic, but also a very interesting character, sort of anti-hero of the sort. And so, first off is the line work. I want to establish the line work first, and like the last time, which I splattered a lot of colours on surface and then go with that. But here I wanted to have all the things marked down so that I won't get lost in process and trying to figure out what I wanted to do in the first place. And next up we're going to talk about my criteria for the pose. And first and foremost is for the audience, or maybe at least yourself, to see very clearly what your character is doing even from far away. So you can try to make a silhouette of your characters by painting the whole of him or her grey, and then you zoom out or you walk a bit backwards to see the smaller version of your portrait to look whether you see what your character is doing. Well, maybe you already have an idea what your character is doing, and so you can ask other people, your friends, to guess what the character is doing by looking at the silhouette for you. And so you can have a more objective feedback. But for me, I just looked at it myself. And the second thing about the pose is to showcase the personality of your character. For example, I saw some of the professional artists who design characters. They would list out a couple of features or personality of the character, and then they would combine these elements into their design. It's sort of like logo design, which does the same thing. For example, if your character is very energetic and you can imagine him doing charming stuff like dancing around, running, and basically doing active poses, and if your character is more reserved and introverted, you can draw him reading or sitting or standing in a sort of introverted way. I'm not sure what that means. To showcase the personality. But while you do that, make sure to also mind the silhouette rule, which is to show your character's pose very clearly. One way to do this is to not let all the limbs overlap each other. For example, imagine a character facing the audience and his hands are scrambled together in front of his chest and his legs are crossed akimbo, and basically everything is overlapped with his torso. And then you imagine this figure is painted wholly in grey, in one colour, and with that, nobody can tell what exactly the character is doing because his big torso is blocking his hands. And what that means is to move your hands, the arms, the legs, or the head away from the central body so that even by looking at the shadow, you'll have a clear idea what sort of thing your character is doing instead of, you know, a blob of indistinguishable mask or something like that. Okay, onward to outfit or costume design. It really depends on the setting of your story or your game or anything in general you have to design your character for. I've seen a lot of people drawing spandex, body tight suits, and very revealing armor, sort of RPG feel sort of characters. You don't have to be like that. You don't always have to draw an RPG avatar for a character design, unless of course your story or your purpose to design is for an RPG setting. Just the most important thing about the outfit design is to it's pretty much the same for poses, is to show meaning. Every part of your painting is to communicate a certain meaning to your audience. For example, you want to showcase the setting of your story, you want to show the personality of your characters. For example, your character is a very lazy person and he stayed at home all day doing nothing, and you can, you know, draw him with a very loose fitted hoodie or something like that. It really doesn't have a strict rule what sort of kind of outfit your character has to wear, but just don't let it be meaningless. You know, I've seen some people draw their original characters, they've put a lot of mind thinking up the story, but when they have to draw them out, a lot of times they, you know, wear a simple t-shirt and pants and running shoes. And why is that? Because it's what they wear themselves, and they want the character to wear the same thing as them during the everyday life. Well, there's nothing wrong with wearing a t-shirt during the day yourself, but for the character, you draw them a t-shirt and it's not meaning anything, and you just want the characters to wear a t-shirt for the sake of wearing a t-shirt, then it's not going to communicate anything from you to your audience. So to put it generally, is to give a meaning to your outfit, and that's it. Okay, onward to drawing the face. You see, so a couple of minutes ago that I was struggling to draw the face. You can scroll back to a few minutes earlier. The face I drew is hideous, it is horrifying. But I corrected it using the liquifying tool and adjusted the colours for a bit, and hopefully it turned out more natural than what I did. I was quite embarrassed to post about that part. I failed at drawing the face, but I told myself I shouldn't hide anything. The main thing I am going to say about drawing faces, it can be a bit debatable, but that's what I learned from my experience of drawing character portraits, is to not put so many details on your face, or at least don't draw the face in the first stage of your painting. The reason is that if you don't have a lot of experience drawing full body portraits, you would be tempted to put a lot of effort into the character's facial expressions. You would turn the brush tool to a very small size and then go for the little details on the face, and it would take up a lot of time, and then when you zoom back and look at the picture as a whole, your details will not be visible at all, and it's going to waste your effort and time. So for full body portraits, don't put so much effort into it, or at least don't put so much detail on the face. Leave it maybe a bit rougher. Keep the detailedness the same, like the clothes, hair, or you can make it a little bit more detailed because it's the face and it has expressions, but don't put so much time into it. If you have this problem, try to exercise by drawing big shapes of shadows on the face first. Then focus your efforts on other parts like the clothing and skin and hair and objects, and basically limit your time on drawing the face, because it is really not that worth it if you put hours on end drawing the face if you're drawing a full body portrait. Okay, I think I have some other things I want to say about drawing faces, but I'm going to leave it for other time, perhaps in another video, because I want to talk about the three values. It's something I learned through some YouTube tutorials and by looking at other artists' artwork. The three values is three different colours for colouring your character. You can imagine three values as the neutral tone, the dark tone, and the light tone. And when you look at my drawing, you can look at the character's hair and his sweater. So what you see there is basically three colours in general. I may add some a little bit of details on the shirt, but I know the hair is minus the highlight, only three colours. And what I did is to see all the shadows and light and forms, imagine them as shapes. And, you know, instead of any other pieces of hair, I just imagined different big shapes of shadow, a large pack of shadow, and then pasted it on the drawing to give the illusion of a form. This technique saved me a lot of time, because before I used to draw, anything with a lot of details, as if I was doing a photorealistic artwork, and I didn't know when to stop with the detail, and so I would put more details into it until I found out that my artwork looked like rubbish. The three value things are not only to stop me from putting too many details in an artwork, but also train me to see the forms of shadow, to see shadows and light as a big large shape, and avoid using gradient. And you can look it up by searching painting light and shadow online, and you'll see a lot of tutorials on that, and some professional artists will tell you exactly what to do and what to look out for. So I highly recommend that. And here's the final result, and hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure to click like and subscribe, or go to inkreverts.com to check out our weekly blog and a weekly updated portfolio. And I'll see you next time. Bye!